Hey, everybody. Hope you're enjoying the session mead that Batch Mead has made for us. We're going to go inside and find out a little bit more about this place. Let's go.
Batch Mead here in Temecula. We've been here about a year and a couple months.
So I've been making mead for 8 or 9 years, and I started with, a wine kit that you bought me for my birthday.
First wine ever.
And then...
it was a wine kit for Chardonnay, but they didn't have Chardonnay grapes, so they gave us Riesling grapes. You cannot make Chardonnay from Riesling grapes. It does not taste good.
So I heard about mead, and I wanted to make that, and I tried it at the grocery store that was nearby our house. I drank a whole case of it, and I was like, this is...
Well, I was on a business trip. Yeah. Gone. Well, come back.
It was great.
3 sheets in the wind.
I was playing Skyrim, and I heard about mead through there in the TV show Vikings, so I wanted to give it a shot, and just loved it after that. Stuck with it. Didn't make wine again.
This is our boysenberry session, so this is one of the first sessions that we've done, but we made a boysenberry pie mead, which is a great flavor. Boysenberry is like a cross between a blackberry and a raspberry, so it has that acidity, and you'll really get that in this mead. So it cuts through, it's about 6% alcohol. We used a local avocado blossom honey, which gives it a lot of earthiness, and that really comes through in this particular mead. And then you've used a new process that we haven't used before.
Right. I introduced lagering into making our meads this time around. So I wanted to do a lager style session. And this is the mead that we're going to try today. So the yeast itself, the lager yeast, is different than our traditional wine yeast that we use. And when I lager, I let it sit for about a month in 50 degrees. Just let it get that rest. Even though there's no diacetyl in mead making per se, it just helps the yeast settle out and gain more complexity.
So we actually knew we wanted to open a meadery when we first moved to the West Coast from the Midwest. We moved to San Francisco and we went all over San Francisco. We lived in Seattle. And then we knew those were not the right places for our meadery. We went back to California, went to Napa, we went to Carmel, all over the coast, San Luis Obispo, Ventura, Santa Barbara, and they just all weren't the right fit. And we came here to Temecula for, like, we were here 5 hours and we were like, this is it. And Temecula is just an amazing community of small businesses and everybody's open to new experiences. There's already an established wine country and brewery scene here and people are just really open to doing new things. And so it became this really perfect fit. And one of the things we wanted to do with our meadery was make it really approachable and something that people wanted to hang out here. We really had this vision to make it somewhere where we would go for like a date night or to hang out, kind of your, you know, fun little corner spot to go to all the time. So we've kind of incorporated that into our design here. So I think for us for 2021, we have a lot of fun things planned. We have a whole series of sessions coming, so that's really exciting for us. And then we do everything really seasonally. So we try lots and lots of honeys, probably a gross amount of honeys, like thousands of honeys. And we match everything back to what we're making. So that's why we have an avocado blossom here. We use everything from orange blossom to almond blossom to Chipotle, honey, just it depends on what we're trying to make. And we map everything back to the different flavor profiles.
Yeah, and then when strawberries bloom in the spring, we pick up strawberries from Kenny Strawberry Farm and any other local farms we can find.
So. Local lemons, local oranges, local persimmons. So we have a persimmon cider coming soon.
Yep.
So that'll be really fun. We try to keep everything really fun and constantly changing. It seems like people really love sweet and they really love the seasonal feel of like getting something local and supporting both our business, but also those local farmers. And for us, what we love doing is having the events here. So we have like magic shows, we were doing little pop-up markets, we had a Viking night, which was really fun. Everybody had a horn, we were eating pizza, we were ringing a gong, people were cheersing. That was a great event. But having those events is really, really fun. And we were kind of sad we missed out because it's our first year. We missed out on all the festivals. So we're hoping those come back. Just like this one, this is fun, virtual. Fresh year, fresh mead.
Yeah, so the reason why we chose this mead for fresh year, fresh beer because it's a lager style yeast and it's something that's new and we've never tried before, but it turned out amazing and I can't wait for you guys to try it.
We had several backups in case it didn't work, so this is perfection. But we also picked this one because of the boysenberries, because it's just such a good flavor to carry through in a session. I think in a lot of cases, sessions can turn out a little light or a little watery, especially with the honey, because you're trying to make it a lower alcohol content. So the boysenberry really carries through in this particular session.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I play Crash Bandicoot, yeah, for sure.
You just played it like 2 days ago.
I just played it last night, honestly. I was reminiscing. I play video games, that's what I do when I'm not here.
And I played Zelda on the little like N64 handheld one. What's that called? Game Boy. I have N64 too, the Mario Kart.
Yep.
There's enough mead to go around sometimes. Thank you for visiting us here at Batch Mead. You can order more of our meads online at batchmead.com. So everything ships locally in California, and we also do cross-state shipping if you want to try more of our fun meads and ciders. And then we're excited to hopefully welcome more people back in 2021. But you can join us here in our really super cool tasting room for more meads and ciders, and we all have them on draft.
Cheers.